I'm wishing on a star and trying to believe that even though it's far, he'll find me Christmas Eve. I guess that Santa's busy, 'cause he's never come around. I think of him when Christmas comes to town.
Welcome to worship at Riviera United Methodist Church. Friends, let us gather our spirits in God's presence this morning. On this day, earth shall ring, Gloria in excelsis Deo. For Christ our Lord has been born for us, the Son given to us, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Love has come down at Christmas, and perfect love has absolved all fear. Friends, let us rejoice this day. For Christ is born, and the angels sing, Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Please join in singing our hymn, On This Day, Earth Shall Ring.
On this day, earth shall ring, with the song children sing, to the Lord Christ our King, born on earth to save us. Him the Father gave us. Ideo, oh, oh, Ideo, oh, oh, Ideo, Gloria in excelsis Deo. His the doom, ours the mirth, when he came. Earth shall ring,
and peace of Jesus Christ be with you. Welcome to worship with the congregation and community of Riviera United Methodist Church. We are so glad that you are joining us today. Today is the first Sunday of Christmas. We are in the great 12 days of Christmas, and so today we are going to be sharing Christmas stories, Christmas memories, and thinking about what this season means to each one of us in our lives. As we gather for worship today, we invite you to just open your hearts once again to receive the gift of Christ Child for you this morning. We're going to begin today with sharing a familiar Christmas story read by Joe and Jackie Farrell, The Friendly Beast. And so we begin today with that story for our children.
The Friendly Beast. Jesus, our brother, kind and good, was humbly born in a stable of wood, and the friendly beast around him stood. Jesus, our brother, kind and good.
"I," said the donkey, shaggy and brown, "I carried his mother up hill and down. I carried him safely to Bethlehem town." "I," said the donkey, shaggy and brown.
"And I," said the cow, all white and red, "I gave him my manger for a bed. I gave him my hay for to pillow his head." "I," said the cow, all white and red.
"I," said the sheep with a curly horn, "I gave him my wool for his blanket warm, and he wore my coat on that Christmas morn." "I," said the sheep with a curly horn.
"I," said the dove from the rafters high, "cooed him to sleep that he should not cry. We cooed him to sleep, my love and I." "I," said the dove from the rafters high.
"And I," said the camel, all yellow and black, "over the desert upon my back, I brought him a gift in the wise men's pack." "I," said the camel, all yellow and black.
Thus every beast, remembering it well, in the stable dark, was so proud to tell of the gifts that they gave Emmanuel, the gifts that they gave Emmanuel.
Just seems like we can't do right.
Please join in singing our centering song, which will be followed by a time of silent prayer. You to just open your hands to be in a spirit and a posture of receiving Christ's love for you today. Loving God, as we come into worship this morning, our hearts are yet full of the joy that is Christmas, the gift of Emmanuel, God with us. We gather today in what has been a most unusual Christmas season, a time where we have perhaps been apart from loved ones and perhaps have experienced your love and this gift of Christmas in new ways. As we center our hearts, God, open us to that gift of your presence. With Mary and Joseph, we journey to this place of Bethlehem. We open ourselves to the gift of Christ. God, where we have been closed, where we have sought to dampen your love, not with conscious thought, but with just a sense of fatigue or resentment or anger or exhaustion, we ask that you renew us. Help us to feel your love for us this day, and help us to extend that love to all those that we meet. God, as we gather this morning as a congregation, we lift up the family of Orley White, and we give thanks for his life and ministry here at Riviera for 16 years. God, we give thanks for all of the ways that his leadership as pastor and friend guided this congregation, and we pray, God, for all who grieve his life today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And God, we lift up our community and our country. We continue to pray for healing and for strength for all of those who are sick with COVID, for those who are caring for our loved ones and broader community in the hospitals, for those who are caring for loved ones at home, for those who are experiencing the loneliness of isolation, either because they are sick or because they are caring for others who are sick. God, we lift our weary hearts To your loving care, we lift those who grieve and who are struggling today, to your tender comfort and mercy. And we lift up all of our community, God, as we continue to run this marathon that is before us of caring for one another. We give thanks, God, for the hope that this vaccine brings and for each person getting inoculated, for the hope and healing and restoring of our community. We give you thanks. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And God, in this season, we continue to pray for our nation, for the turmoil and pain that we are experiencing, for the distrust and discord that is among us. God, we pray that you would guide us. Help us as Christians, as disciples, to be witnesses to your light and to your love, to be ambassadors of peace and healing in our country. Guide us, we pray. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, we lift to you all the prayers that are on our hearts this morning. We each carry with us joys that we lift in love and adoration to you, and we carry with us heartaches. We lift them all to your love and to your mercy. We lift our prayers in the name of Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The Old Testament reading today is Isaiah 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walk in darkness will see a great light, a light that will shine on all who live in the land where death casts its shadow. Israel will again be great, and its people will rejoice as people rejoice at harvest time. They will shout with joy like warriors dividing the plunder, for God will break the chains that bind his people and the whip that scourges them, just as he did when he destroyed the army of Midian with Gideon's little band. In the day of peace, battle gear will no longer be issued. Never again will uniforms be blood-stained by war. All such equipment will be burned. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us, and the government will rest on its shoulders. There will be his royal titles, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His ever-expanding, peaceful government will never end. He will rule forever with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor David. The passionate commitment of the Lord Almighty will guarantee this. The word of the Lord, thanks be to God.
Not too many Christmas carols have been written by Americans. One of my favorites is O Little Town of Bethlehem. On Christmas Eve of 1865, Philip Brooks, beloved pastor of Philadelphia's Holy Trinity Church, was traveling in the Holy Land. On horseback, he rode out of the city of Jerusalem, which was crowded with tourists, to seek comfort and inspiration in the open desert. Young Brooks had led and comforted his congregation through a terrible civil war, but Lee's surrender on April 9th did not bring the desired peace when Abraham Lincoln was assassinated just a few days later. Brooks was such an admired orator that he was invited to speak at Lincoln's funeral. Depression lingered, however, and it was hoped that a visit to the land of Jesus' birth would be an inspiration.
The nighttime horseback ride led across open country where shepherds and their flocks might indeed gather, where the starry night sky seemed the very atmosphere in which angels might appear. Approaching the tiny ancient village of Bethlehem, Brooks was touched by the narrow streets and dwellings, unchanged for centuries. He felt closer to God and to our Lord than he had ever felt before.
On returning home, Brooks tried to put into words his renewed inspiration, but daily responsibilities seemed to take over. One night, as Christmas of 1868 approached, the simple words flowed out of him. O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. He urged his church organist, Louis Redner, to compose a melody. At first, Redner struggled to develop a magnificent composition to express these beautiful words, but finally he allowed a simple, flowing melody to carry the moving poetry.
Within a few years, almost every church in Philadelphia was singing the carol, distributed as an inexpensive leaflet. In 1874, the words and music were included in the Church Porch, a national musical collection by William Huntington. The song would become one of the world's most beloved carols.
O Holy Child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in, be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. O come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
This is Rosemary Zettler, and one of my cherished Christmas memories is from my childhood. We lived on an isolated cattle ranch in Montana, and my dad and brothers, when they were out riding during the year, would keep a lookout for an appropriate little Christmas tree, chop it down a couple of days before Christmas, but it didn't go up until Christmas Eve, after we six kids had been tucked into bed and were asleep. Christmas morning then, when we rushed down the stairs, we were greeted by a wondrous, exciting, colorfully decorated Christmas tree and a box of homemade Christmas cookies under it. Almost more special, though, for me was the evening of Christmas Day. Only then were the clip-on candles that were attached to the branches of the tree lighted. They were about 3 inches long, and they would burn for probably less than an hour, and always someone was specifically assigned to watch the tree to guard against an accidental fire. I loved the enchanted view, and particularly when it was my turn to watch the lighted candles.
Merry Christmas from the Hines family. I'm Bella.
I'm Patrick.
And I'm Kristen.
I would say my favorite memory was probably from when I was about 4 years old for the Christmas pageant. I was dressed up as Mary and I was holding a baby Jesus doll, and there was a baby Jesus doll in the manger. So there were two baby Jesus dolls, and I started crying on stage because there were two baby Jesus dolls.
My favorite memory was decorating the tree with the youth group, and every year I would always break an ornament, and not on purpose at all. It would just somehow happen. I don't know.
And my favorite memory is always doing the candlelight service, because I grew up at my church doing candlelight service on Christmas Eve, so I'm glad to share that with my children.
Well, those are our favorite memories. Merry Christmas, everyone, and stay safe. We miss you all.
Merry Christmas.
Hi, everyone. Just wanted to share one of my favorite Christmas memories at Riviera growing up was always going caroling with the youth group. It was a really fun chance for all of us to go out into the community wearing our most ridiculous sweaters and the most obnoxious holiday gear that we could find, and bringing cheer to the homebound and people of the church that maybe didn't get to come into church as much, and kind of spread a little Christmas cheer with our loud singing. I remember fondly that one of our favorite songs to sing was Silent Night, because it had a German verse and none of us spoke German, and we all tried every year. And that probably was one of my favorite memories, just getting all together and, you know, really incorporating the people of the church. And I think especially this year that rings true, that even though we can't all be together, our church has always found a way to make it so it feels like that we are. Another memory, just adding to that, was our parties that we would have afterwards. We would do, I think they're called progression parties. I think there might be another name for it, but you'd start at one house and you'd have an appetizer, and then we'd all drive to another house and we'd have another appetizer, and then we'd go and have a main course somewhere, and then we'd have dessert somewhere. And it was a really cool chance to meet everybody's families, and, you know, just spread cheer everywhere we went.
We come together today in celebration of the birth of Christ. We've celebrated and reflected on the gifts of hope, peace, joy, and love that he brought to the world. The holidays are the season for giving, encouraging each of us to find opportunities to give of ourselves, both personally and financially, especially this year. In gratitude for God's faithfulness in our lives, we invite you to make an offering in support of our ministries of sharing God's love, hope, and healing in the world. We sincerely appreciate your ongoing support for the ministries of this church. If you would like to make an offering at this time, the various ways you contribute are displayed on your screen. Thank you. got a vision. Take these offerings and turn them into vision. Vision of all people fed, vision of all people safe, vision of all people housed, vision of all people educated. Amen.
Please join in singing our hymn, Angels We Have Heard on High. For joining us for worship today. I want to say a special thank you to those who shared with us their Christmas stories and memories. We're so grateful to share those memories and to remember our own Christmas stories this week. As you go into this week, we are still in the season of Christmas. We are still in a season of sharing God's love and joy and peace with everyone we meet. And so as you go into this week, may the love of God who created you and called you to life, may the peace of Christ, who came to be born in all of our hearts, and may the companionship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and always. Amen.